Hello everyone. Today I am going to explain about the surgical hand scrubbing technique, which is a very essential and very important step before doing any clinical procedure or a surgical procedure. Surgical site infections are a potent threat to patient safety, and proper surgical scrubbing techniques are essential to decrease this incidence. The video is going to provide you information on the method of surgical scrubbing, and the method followed in this video is called the brush stroke method. So what we intend to get by doing a proper surgical scrubbing? We get a clean nails, hands and forearms, and to reduce the microbial count and to inhibit microorganism regrowths. It normally takes 3 to 5 minutes for the entire scrubbing procedure to be completed. Before you start the procedure, you should remove all the jewelry or any foreign objects in the fingers, and there should not be any cuts or wounds in the arms and fingers. And any foreign bodies or any acrylic or any foreign objects like artificial nails and any jewelry items should be removed. That is very, very essential before doing the hand scrubbing technique. You should have a proper personal protective equipment placed, with the head cap properly placed, and it should be tugged so that the ears and the hair should be inserted inside the head cap, and there should be a proper face shield and a proper surgical mask placed before starting the brushing technique. Pre-washing is very, very essential before starting the brushing or the scrubbing technique. If it is the first case of the day, or if the hands are visibly soiled, pre-washing the hands and the arms is very essential before starting the surgical scrubbing technique. First, you should use a disposable nail picks to clean the nail beds under the fingernails and in running water. This is very, very essential to remove the bacterial deposits as well as any kind of a soiled material in the fingernails and the nail beds. And it should be disposed properly. The disposable nail picks should be disposed properly. Then you should wash your hands and forearms in running water to remove the any remaining foreign bodies or any pathological material or any soiled material in the arms. Then you should remove sterile surgical sponge or soap from the wrapper, and you should moisten the sponge or the soap under running water very well, and by squeezing and dispensing it properly within the palms. First, you should brush the fingertips in a very regular, firm, back and forth motion, approximately around 30 times. First, you should start with one arm and you should brush with the sterile surgical sponge or the soap in the fingers and the nail beds, and you should do it, the direction should be back and forth, approximately 30 times. Now we should start the inner aspect of the palm, back and forth motion. We should start from the wrist area towards the fingers. So we should start from the wrist area towards the fingers, back and forth. This can be done around 10 times. Next is the outer surface of the palm or the hand, which is the dorsum of the hand. We should start from the wrist towards the fingers, back and forth motion, around 10 times. It should be the motion should be back and forth, and the force what we exert while scrubbing should be firm. Next, we should go to the outer surface of the thumb, that is the lateral aspect of the thumb. It should be the strokes should be the same strokes, firm strokes, back and forth around 10 times. Then the inner portion of the thumb, that is the medial portion of the thumb, around 10 times, the same firm back and forth strokes. Similarly, other fingers, each and every finger, mesial as well as the distal at the lateral aspects, you should do the same back and forth motion with firm strokes around 10 times each side. Very important, when you finish one area, do not go back to the before area. That is very, very important. So, very important is when you scrub the one area, that is, for example, if you start with the thumb and go to the index finger, you should not go back to the thumb. Now, it is a time to scrub the arms. Mentally, you divide the forearm into three portions, that is 3 1/3 from the wrist to the 2 inches above the elbow. So, you can each and every area you should concentrate, and you start from the 1/3 which is near the wrist from the dorsal surface, then the ventral surface. Same firm back and forth strokes, 10 strokes on the dorsal surface, then go to the ventral surface on the first 1/3 and the second 1/3 you should start from the dorsal surface, stroke, you should use the stroke and brush it properly and go to the ventral surface. Similarly, you should continue till the you reach the third 1/3 portion which is 2 inches above the elbow. Repeat the scrub on the other arm and the hand. For example, we start with the left hand, you can start the same strokes to the right hand. Now, start rinsing properly from the fingertips slowly towards the elbow. From the forearm, from the fingertips, slowly you should start rinsing from the fingertips towards the elbow. You should not go back. Actually, when you start from the fingertips, go to the wrist and the forearm, you're not supposed to go towards the fingertips again. Always keep your elbow in the 90 degree angulation. This is very important when you do the rinsing of the water. Do not move arms back and forth in the water when you rinse the arms and hands. Main warning is that if you touch any surface, you should repeat the entire procedure from the starting. That is very, very essential. Once rinsing is completed and no antiseptic or soap material is seen on the hands and the arms, turn off the water with the knee control preferably. This is very, very important. When you should turn off the water with the knee control if it is available. Allow residual water to drip off the elbows into the sink. Main thing is do not shake or wave hands to remove the excess water. This is very, very essential. You should not shake hands or move the hands when you in order to drain the water. This is the entire procedure which is called the brush stroke method to be employed when we do a hand scrubbing technique. Thank you very much.